Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create recognizable silhouette drawings that are made from one or two continuous chalk lines. Open a profile of your subject. I downloaded this one from Shutterstock. Open your crop tool. Make your document's width 1550 pixels, its height 870 pixels, and its resolution 150 pixels per inch. Go to a corner and drag it in or out to size your image. Drag inside your image to reposition it within the crop boundaries. Continue until you're happy with its size and position. Then, click the check mark at the top. To fit your document back onto your canvas, press Ctrl or Command 0. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. We'll fill it with black. To do this, press Shift plus the F5 key at the top of your keyboard to open the Fill window. Open the Contents list and click Black. Then click OK. Decrease its opacity to 50% so we can see your subject through it. Open your pen tool. Choose Path. If you're using version CS5 or earlier, the Path icon is here. Go to an outside edge of your subject where you'd like to begin. Click your mouse or pen and release. Go to the nearest point on your subject and click to make a straight path from your first point. Release and click next to your first point. Release again and click next to your second point. Continue these steps to make connecting paths over your subject. Don't be concerned about areas that are outside the direction of your paths. We'll take care of them in a minute. Make the points closer together where your subject turns on the inside, and make the distance of the points wider where your subject turns on the outside. End the paths with shorter lengths. Open the Paths panel. Click the icon at the upper right corner and click Save Path. When you see this window, click OK. If you have an area of your subject that needs paths, repeat the same steps to make them. Then, open the flyout list, click Duplicate Path, and click OK. If you have another area of your subject that needs paths, just repeat the steps. Open back the Layers panel and make the black layer's opacity 100%. If you have a path that you'd like to connect to another path, go to the point of the path you want to extend and click on it. Press and hold Ctrl or Command as you drag the path to the top of the other path and release. Open the Paths panel and, as before, click Duplicate Path and click OK. Open the Layers panel. Open your Pencil tool and Pencil Picker. Click the gear icon and click Dry Media Brushes. Click OK to replace your current brushes with the dry media brushes. Click the gear icon again and click Small List. Scroll down and click Hard Charcoal Edge. Make the size 2 pixels and press Enter or Return. Press the F5 key at the top of your keyboard to open your brush panel. Click Brush Tip Shape. The spacing is 5%. Check Space Dynamics and open it. Make the size jitter 100%. Check and click Scattering. Make the scatter amount 300, the count 5, and the count jitter 100%. Check and open texture. The scale and depth are 100%. Check and open dual brush. The size is 12 pixels. The spacing is 25%. The scatter is 0%. And the count is 1. We want white to be your foreground color. If it isn't, press D on your keyboard to make your colors black and white respectively, and then either press X or click this icon to invert them. We can close the brush panel now. Open the Paths panel and click Stroke Path. Choose Pencil and check Simulate Pressure. Then click OK. To hide the paths, click anywhere on an empty area of the Paths panel. Open the Layers panel and Control-click or Command-click on the New Layer icon to make a new layer below the active layer. We'll fill the empty layer with black, and since black is the background color, press Control or Command plus Delete. Make the top layer active and open your lasso tool. Draw a selection around your chalk drawing. Press Ctrl or Command J to cut and copy the drawing to its own layer. Click the eyeball icon next to the original drawing to hide the layer. Open your transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. Click the warp icon. Click the Custom tab and click Arch. By dragging your cursor on the word bend to the left or right, you can adjust how much bend your drawing will have. By clicking the Warp Orientation icon, it will instantly change its horizontal or vertical orientation. For this image, I prefer the horizontal orientation, however, feel free to experiment with your image to see which orientation works best for your drawing. When you're happy with your image, press Enter or Return, or click the check mark at the top. If you have a group of lines that you'd like to manipulate, carefully make a selection around the group and press Ctrl or Command J to cut and copy them to its own layer. Open your Transform tool and click the Warp icon. To manipulate the shape, drag the control points or a segment of the bounding box. When adjusting a curve, use the control point handles. Then press Enter or Return. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.